have been seeing the shlokas. Sarvam janiti pranaha chetom shun purusha prithak. Prana is creating chetom shun, that is the jivas essentially. It is, now it is referring to O Vishwadara, Tejasa and Prajna. In general, others also are included. They all come gradually. Okay? Now, when they are coming, okay. And it is told, Prabhava Sarvabhavanam Satamiti Vinishchaya. Sarvanjaniti Prana. Katham? Yukte. Deva Manushya Tiryagadi Bhede Deha Bhedeshu Vibhavyamanaha Chetom Shvaha Ye Tan Purusha Prithak Vishabhavilakshan Agnivispulingavat Sarakshan Jalar Kavacha Jivalakshan Stuitaran Sarabhav Sarabhav Sarabhavan Pranaha Bijatma Janayati. Okay. He creates all this, all these jivas are also created. Now, in this connection, he has quoted the mantra Yathornanabhis Srijate Grinatecha. The example is given. Just as this spider creates the web. Okay. Now it creates the web and it swallows that also. And it does not need the help of anybody else. It all does it by itself. It also swallows itself. Therefore, similarly, here also, everything is coming from Brahman and going back into it. Okay. All this description is intended only to show that everything is Brahman. Remember that. It may be a pictorial language, it may be very logical, all this, whatever it is. The purpose is to show that everything is Brahman. Okay. Therefore, another example is, there is a big fire. Okay. Now, all the sparks are coming out. Sparks are coming out. There is some difference here. This example. Now, what does it show here? The vispulinga, there is a sparks. The sparks are not entirely different from the fire. Because they have got the same feature. There is a little light. There is a little heat. Okay. But they are separated. Okay. Why this example is given? Whatever may happen to the jivas. Okay. It is not going to affect Brahman. See. When you say they are all Brahman only. One question raises. Every jiva is a Brahma. Therefore, the pain of every jiva, is it experienced by Brahman also? Have you understood the question? Therefore, it is not so. In fact, various arguments are given. Just as the pot, when pot is broken, clay is not broken. Even though it is sticking to it, the pot is sticking to the clay. But in spite of it, clay is not broken just because the pot is broken. Similarly here, though Brahman is here, actually it doesn't get affected by our contact. Okay. Now, in the case of the in order to show that nothing happened, this example is given. No, you should not take these examples literally. Okay. Why literally? Because if you really take that Brahman is something like fire and it goes out, one part of it went away, another part went away, another part went away, like that, it will create holes wherever something has gone out. Okay. Now it will act as a sort of a gap, therefore its impulse, there are cramps will be there, therefore it will cause a lot of pain to Brahman. Do you agree? Okay. What does it say? Avrana. With Avrana, Brahman doesn't have wounds. See, you must be surprised. Why Upanishad talk that God has no wounds? When it says God has no wounds, you have to understand its full meaning. That is why various examples are given. God has no wounds. Therefore, if you take it as a part of Jiva, as a part of him, then you will start getting wounds. It is not so. Therefore, when you say Kshudra Vispulingaha, like spark, it is in this sense, it is not different from Brahman. Now, even this limitation that you find in the Jiva, he is not inherent in him. In what sense? There is limitation in the Jiva because my buddhi is limited, because it is impure. There is karma, there is avidya. Okay. Actually, that is not my inherent nature. It has come from outside. Okay. Therefore, I am getting affected. Therefore, though I may look like different, I am really not different. So similarly, this example is given. When sparks are, they may look like different, but they are not different from fire. Okay? Now, the examples are given. Now finally it says, yesterday it was told, Vibhutim prasapantvanye manyante srikshintakaha svapna maya sarupeti srikshiranyir vikalpita. That the various descriptions that people give are being mentioned here. Okay. You have heard yesterday. Different descriptions are given. Okay. So, Bhagavan Bhashyakara says, at the end, Ataha tat chintayame adaro mukshunam haryanam na nishprayojanam srishto adaraha. That is, people who are interested in moksha, they are not very much seriously bothered about srishti process. The process of srishti, they are not bothered. Okay. See, these sentences have been misunderstood. How misunderstood, I will tell you. In different Upanishads, different starting points are given for srishti. In Brahmaranya it says, it started from water. Okay. In Chandogya it says, it has started from Agni. Okay. Therefore, different things are there. And in some places, there is not even scheme. This order is not there. Simply everything is mentioned. These things were created. Therefore, there are many people who say that Shruti, it doesn't decide correctly the scheme, the sequence. It doesn't there. Therefore, this you need not take the Shruti seriously. They make this statement. But Śankarācārya vehemently denies it. It is not so. There cannot be this type of differences. Because if there is really a difference, what would happen? People would lose faith in the Shruti. Śankarācārya mentions very clearly, especially in Brihadaranya. He says, you have to take when this jala means, after akasha, after vayu, after agni, after jala. From there it starts. You have to take it only. Otherwise, there will be contradiction. And Śruti does not entertain contradiction. Acha. But in some places, there is no sequence given. Everything is simply mentioned. All these things were created, it says. There is no sequence there. Then he says, this is only paṭha-karma. That is, simply make a listing, that is all. There is no sequence, no sequence is involved. Okay? Therefore, do not misread it. When Bhāṣyakāra says, Srishti is not a serious matter for mumukshu, the meaning is the following. What is the serious matter for mumukshu? That is, everything is non-different from Brahman. That knowledge is most important for the mumukshu. How you establish it is not very serious. You establish it whatever you want. Okay. But if you mention Srishti, then it has to give a karma. There is no doubt about that. Okay. Now comes the most important thing. Here, the Srishti is being described not in the sequence of creation. It is telling Indro Maya Vipurupa Iyate Iti Shrutehe. Nahi Mayavinam Sutram Akashe Nikshipya Tena Savidham Aruhya Chakshur Gojaratam Atitya Yudhena Kandashchenam Patitam Punurutitam Chavashadam Tatkratamaya Satatuchintayam Madraha Bhavati Tathiva Ayam Mayavinah Sutra Prasanasamaha Suṣupta Svapnadi Vikasaha. That is, it's telling, there is a Mayavi. What does he do? He is simply throwing a rope, he climbs there, going, he is hitting, some people are killed and all that. Actually, people are all seeing there, this fellow is standing here looking at these people. Okay. They are looking at the rope and he is looking at them. Okay. Similarly, here also, the example is, all this is created. That is, what is the example given? Maya is simply hypnotizing audience. He is simply showing some things, you know. Similarly, Bhagavan is standing here. Who is Bhagavan? Turīya ātmā. Standing here. All these projections are made. What does this imply? This example implies that this is all mithya. Isn't it so? It is not there. There is no stuff there. I suppose all of you have understood. Frequently in the Shastra, what do you see? You see examples of kārikāna bhāva and also you see svapna. It is maya. It is just fake. It is also there. Therefore, the two are not at all the same. They are very different. How should we understand? Have all of you understood the question? For the same world, two descriptions are given. What are the descriptions? Just as there is stuff, the pot coming from clay, like this. Therefore, Brahman is there in everything. Therefore, everything is Sat, Sat. All this is Sat, it has been told in the very first shloka. Everything is Sat, it has been told. After having told that all these things are existing, Sat. Now if you give the example, Maya Sarupa, Swapna Maya Sarupa. What does it mean? It's like Maya. Okay, just mesmerism. Or Swapna, Swapna. In Swapna and this mesmerism, there is no stuff there. It is not Sat. Therefore, the two descriptions are opposite to each other. How to reconcile? Have you understood? No, they can't be really opposite. Therefore, there must be some meaning there. What exactly is the meaning? Okay. Now remember, what you cannot give up is that it is Sat. You can't give it up. It is Sat. Though it is Sat, it is called like this. Why? In what sense? Have you understood? Because Sat is a committed statement. Everything is Brahman. Brahma Vedam Vishwam. Therefore, it is Sat only. You cannot deny that. What you are denying is, it is only a svapna, Rupta. That should be understood properly in this context. Okay? Now, today also, you will have to be very alert. Okay? See, how this creation takes place, you see. You have seen that sequence? There is avyakrita. From avyakrita emerges prana first. And from that avyakta, after that avyakta, avyakta is the seed of all the inert world. And prana is the force field. Now, from this avyakta, first emerges Mahat. Okay. Then emerges Ahankara. Then emerges Tanmatrani, Pancha Tanmatrani. Okay. Now see. All this is Prakriti. That is Brahman's Prakriti. Avyakta, Mahat, Ahankara, Panchatanmatrani is Apara Prakriti. And Prana is Para Prakriti. Okay. Now, here afterwards, creation has to take place. These are all Prakriti. Okay. Now, Vikriti has to take place. What is Vikriti? Vikriti is Vikara. Has to take place. Now, for that to take place, you certainly need intelligence, thinking. That is the first step. In fact, in all actions, what is it that comes first? So our thought process, decision. Okay. It is only after we decide, we think over how to do. First the decision comes, and then we know how to execute this plan. Okay. Therefore, this buddhi is the one which decides. Manas is the thing which plans. Now, what happens is, the first thing, the first birth is, from Mahat emerges Buddhi. And from Ahankara emerges Manas. This you have all heard. This is Hiranyagarbha. Okay. Huh? Mahat is the pregnancy, in pregnancy of Hiranyagarbha. Mahat and Ahankara, pregnancy states. It is from there it is born. It is in Garbhavastha. Mahat and Ahankara are Garbhavastha of Hiranyagarbha. Okay. Now you see, there is a question from your side. What is that? For further creation, something has to be created. Therefore, you need intelligence. You need manas for planning. Okay, let it be. But how did this come about? From avyakrita, prana came, avyakta came, mahat came, ahankara came, tanmatrani came. There was no buddhi at all at that time. How did they come? Have all of you understood this question? Therefore, remember, this whole thing is programmed. This whole thing is programmed. There is an eternal computer program that it should happen. But where a slightly different thing is necessary than a program, and the human beings enter because they have got free will. Have you understood? Because jivas come, jivas have free will. You can't make just a machine and give it to them. Because their karma is there, they want to act in some way, one wants to act in this way, another wants to act in another way. They have got different desires, different abilities. Therefore, it is to be thought out and done. It can't be automatic. Have you understood this point? Up to this, it is automatic. It is a program. Afterwards, it cannot be automatic. Because human beings, creatures, free will is involved there. Therefore, they accumulate their own peculiar karma according to their own samskara. Therefore, the creation of their bodies, it should be according to their karma. Therefore, somebody has to plan at that time.
Because the whole thing is programmed, even till this point, it means there is a tension somewhere which is programmed.
That's right, Brahman.
So how do we separate this intelligence now?
That is exactly what I am telling. See, that does not need changes. That is, suddenly guests came. Your plan is something. Okay.
To give that something is changed.
No. Let me explain once again. After, this is prakriti. When vikriti has to be produced, it is for whose sake? It is for the sake of jivas. Have you followed? No, jivas are crazy. Each person has his own fascinations, desires and all that. Therefore, he has done peculiar karma of his own. For them, they have to be given suitable places. Have you understood now? Therefore, there will be thinking. See, for instance, in routine, you will be doing some food preparation. Okay. Now, somebody comes, you have to plan. If there are more people, you have to plan. I understood now. Therefore, it is in the up to prakriti level, it doesn't need intelligence. It is automatic. Therefore, it is programmed. As soon as jivas enter, then you will have to have planning. Is it clear? Therefore, buddhi and manas are created. Remember, buddhi is actually matter. Buddhi is matter. Remember this. But it's a very subtle matter. Very subtle matter. Okay. How do you say subtle matter? Because in the case of, say, creatures. Buddhi needs food. It is the subtlest part of food is buddhi. It goes to the buddhi. Therefore, it is physical. So, Śankarācārya says, our buddhi is physical. He calls it as bhautika. Bhautika is physical. But it's very subtle. But Hiranyagarbha's buddhi is abhautika. It doesn't need food. Okay. Therefore, buddhi and ahankara, they are produced first.
Buddhi and manas.
Yeah, right. Buddhi and manas. Mahat and ahankara are they? Oh, before that, in prakriti. Now see carefully. This is Hiranyagarbha. Now he has to create this sun, everything has to come from him. Okay. How he should create? If he has to create the sun, Shastra gives so many details. In fact, there are code words for creation. Okay. That is, when he has to create, say, all planets, there is a code word. Okay. And when he has to create human beings, there is a code word. The devatas, there is a code word. Therefore, he knows the meaning of the code words. At the moment the code word is uttered, he remembers everything. How? He was one in the previous creation. He knows it. And he is extraordinarily learned. He has done a lot of tapas also. Therefore, he knows the entire process. That is why he has been selected. First he is trained. There is no question of apprenticeship here. He has to be trained and fixed once for all. Okay? See, he can't do things by trial and error. See, when you are learning cycling, you will say, sometimes you have to fall and get up, that's all. Then you will get it. But suppose you have to drive a plane. Sometimes one or two times you will have to fall and all that. Can you say that? Where it's actually flying an aircraft, you can't take trials. You have to do it. Till then they will give you training. Similarly here also, he can't make trial and all. He has to do it. Therefore, he is such a top intellect and manas. Now, what does he do? He gets the thought of the object that is to be produced. So, in buddhi, he gets the thought of every object that is to be produced. Is it clear? Now, that is called buddhi pratyaya. Or buddhi parikalpita. What is buddhi parikalpita? In buddhi, he has done the kalpana. Of what? Not some his own crazy thoughts. What he has already known. He knows the Surya. Therefore, that picture of Surya first will come. That is buddhi parikalpita Surya. Have you understood this? Now, afterwards, she takes these tanmatras, okay, mixes them properly and creates the whole object. Right? Now see, the difference between the object that he has created and the buddhi parikalpita object. See the relation. Are you following me? First he has thought of it, that is buddhi parikalpita Surya. Now he put all tanmatras, everything into it, and he has put there. Now Surya is ready. Now what is the difference between this and what is the similarity, you see? Now this is the thought of Surya. Surya was not there in front of him. He has remembered the Surya, Smriti. And Smriti, though it is a mental picture, it is not a wrong picture. It is a correct picture. That is, it corresponds exactly to the object. Okay. Therefore, Smriti, Smriti of the object. Therefore, it is yathavat jnana, as it is. Yatha asti tatha. Just as it is. Okay. Now see. Therefore, this buddhi parikalpita Surya is not different from the object, Surya. You understand that? The buddhi parikalpita Surya is not different from the object Surya. Is it clear or not? It is its own picture.
Except one has got the tanmatra.
Ah, you are right. They are not identical. Okay. There is a tanmatra, is there? There is stuff there. Here there is no stuff. There is only a thought. Is it clear? Therefore, this thought is not different from that object, but the object is different from the thought. Are you understanding this statement? This thought is not different from the object, but the object is different from the thought. Why? Because the object is more substantial. There is no substance here. It is corresponding to that. Therefore, this is not different. Suppose this is different and that is different. Then it is mithyajnana. It is not mithyajnana. It is correct jnana. Samyajnana. Therefore, remember this important statement. This buddhi parikalpita Surya is not different from the Surya, object Surya. But the object Surya is different from the buddhi parikalpita Surya.
How is the actual Surya different from the buddhi parikalpita Surya?
There is no stuff here. There is only stuff there. Stuff is only there.
What is the stuff there?
It is Surya with tanmatra. He has put tanmatras and mixed and put it. Therefore, there is prakriti there. There is prakriti, there is upadana karana is there. Here there is no upadana karana. How all of you follow?
buddhi and manas, the physical position of that buddhi and manas.
Yeah, from mahat comes buddhi and from ahankara comes buddhi, manas.
The physical, that day you told us, suṣupti ātmā is at the joint of the four corners of the heart. Buddhi, the physical position of buddhi and manas.
Golak kya hai?
Position of buddhi
and manas. No, Golak is meant only for indriyas generally.
Physical position of buddhi and manas.
Physical position of buddhi and manas themselves are there. That is the position. That itself is the field. That is his position. I understand this. There is no question of adhyatma. He is adhidaivata. See, in the case of creatures coming afterwards, there is a buddhi. Further, there must be a support. But buddhi itself is there. Therefore, its support is only Brahman only. Its support is directly Brahman. There is no intermediate support.
You see, that describes the buddhi,
guha
in the heart. You know,
are, no buddhi, this buddhi is different. This is bhautika. That is abhautika. That is Hiranyagarbha. It's full of tapas. Too big. Therefore, don't compare that with this. It's a spark of that. It has sprung from there, but it is full of dirt. There's no comparison between the two. It's too big. I suppose it's made clear.
That means it's only part of Hiranyagarbha. Not the
buddhi of everybody is only a part of Hiranyagarbha. It's the same buddhi. Okay. So now see, this buddhi parabhut surya is not different from the object surya, but the object surya is different from this buddhi parabhut surya. Have you understood now? Now see,
the object surya, physical stuff, object surya. But my confusion is that doesn't it come from panch mahabhut? And tanmatras are vibration.
That's right.
So,
I have included all that.
How can that come?
I have included all that. He is doing it. He himself has done it. He has mixed panchabhutas and all that he is doing now. Okay. Now see. After this process is described, you will recognize, just as a pot, clay and pot maker, what is it is happening? It is prakriti is upadana. For surya, etc., jagat. And Hiranyagarbha is nimitta. Have you understood? It is like the pot maker. The upadana does not belong to him. It is different. Is it clear? Therefore, now he takes it and he has prepared as nimitta karna. Now see, for everything, there is a nimitta karna and an upadana karna. In this case also, it is satisfied now. The upadana karna is prakriti itself. The nimitta karna is Hiranyagarbha. Is it not so? And the karya is the surya. Now see, surya is nothing but prakriti. It's only vikara of prakriti. Therefore, it is not different from prakriti. And prakriti is only the shakti of Brahman. Therefore, eventually, Surya is not different from Brahman. Following? Surya is not different from Prakriti, and Prakriti is not different from Brahman. Therefore, Surya is not different from Brahman. This is with respect to Upadana Karana. Now come to Nimitta Karana. This buddhi pratyaya of surya He is not different from Surya. And Surya is not different from Brahman. Therefore, through Nimitta Karana also, it is only Ananya. That is, Nimitta Karana is also not different from Brahman. Upadana Karana is also, I mean Surya is also not different from Brahman. That is Hiranyagarbha, is Nimitta Karana. The one who is possessing this is Hiranyagarbha. Okay. Therefore, what has happened? Whether you look through the Nimitta Karana or the Upadana Karana, Ananyatva is there, non-difference is there. Have you followed? Nimitta Karana is also not different. But in the case of pot maker, it is not so. You remember this. In the case of pot maker, this buddhi parikalpana of the pot is not different from the pot. But pot is different from this. But pot is non-different from clay. But Nimitta Karana, the pot maker is different only. Have you understood? Here is difference. But there in the case of Hiranyagarbha, who is Nimitta Karana for the Jagat. Okay. Even through him also it is Ananya. That is why you say, Brahman is Abhinna Nimitta Upadana Karana. Upadana Karana is also Brahman. Nimitta Karana is also Brahman. Is it clear? Now see the next complication. The next complication is the next complication is between Nimitta Karana and Brahman, there is no Karya Karana Bhava. See, between Surya and Brahman, there is a Karya Karana Bhava. Surya is Karya. Karya is a Prakriti Upadana. Prakriti is not different. Therefore, there is a Karya Karana Bhava between Surya and Brahman. But there is no Karya Karana Bhava between Hiranyagarbha and Brahman. No Karya Karana Bhava. Why there is no Karya Karana Bhava? Remember, Hiranyagarbha, Jiva, is not produced. Najayate mriyadeva kadachan, naim bhutva bhavitavan bhuya. Hiranyagarbha is not Karya. Buddhi is Karya, not Hiranyagarbha. Have you followed or not? Between Hiranyagarbha and Brahman, there is no Karya Karana Bhava.
There is no
Vikar. Hiranyagarbha is not a Vikari. Hiranyagarbha is Jiva, is ever existing. Hiranyagarbha was whatever he was in previous Janma, even now he is the same thing.
So also all the Jivas.
Always remember, when you say Najayate Mriyateva, you are applying it to whom? To the Suṣuptātmā. Have you understood or not? Suṣuptātmā is not born. is always there. There is nothing to be born and nothing to die. Therefore, there is no kārikāna bhāva between jīva and Brahman, or Hiranyagarbha and Brahman.
Swamiji, the form-maker is actually
Vaishvanara. I am now calling him as Hiranyagarbha, that's all. You plus Vaishvanara. All things will go on. Have all of you followed what I say?
Swamiji,
this kārikāna bhāva comes only on the body. Ah, you are right. Kārikāna bhāva comes, that too only with respect to the body. As far as jīva is concerned, he is never produced. He never dies. He is as he is. But with respect to the karanas, if you take, he has to create. Therefore, whether the body or the sthula sharira or the sukshma sharira, they are karya. There is no doubt about it. It also comes under the world itself. It comes under kshetra. Therefore, there is karya karana bhava between the sharira, whether sthula or sukshma, and Brahman. There is no doubt about that. But not for the jiva. Is it clear? Have all of you understood this? Okay. Now see, there is kārikāna bhāva there, and therefore ananyatva. You have proved ananyatva. No, there is no kārikāna bhāva here. But you have also proved ananyatva. Ananyatva is common between the two. What? Both the kshetra, that is Surya, and also the nimitta karana. From both point of view, there is ananyatva, non-difference. Have you followed or not? There is a karya. Take the example of Surya. Surya is there. That is a karya. No, for that karya, there is a nimitta karana and an upadana karana. Upadana karana is Brahman itself. Okay. Therefore, the karya karana bhava has come. Therefore, ananyatva has come. No, between Hiranyagarbha and Brahman, there is no karya karana bhava. But in spite of it, through buddhi, ananyatva is established. Buddhi parikalpana. So what is the moral? The moral is, ananyatva is definitely there, whether there is kārikāna bhāva or there is no kārikāna bhāva. Suppose all of you are following? Now you see the examples. When kārikāna bhāva is there, you give murdghata drishtānta, pot clay. When kārikāna bhāva is not there, but ananyatva should be there, what is the example to be given? Rajya sir. You followed? You understand? Therefore, Rajjasarpa Drishtanta is given for the Ananyatva of the Jiva of the Nimitta Karana with Brahman, and for the Ananyatva of the object with Brahman, through kārikās bhāva it is established. Okay. That is why Śankarācārya's remarkable sentence is there. Just remember only one lesson. Śankarācārya's sentences are so pregnant with meaning. If you go on studying it for 10 years, afterwards you will get some new information. Completely new. Abba, abba. How much information is there? You will be surprised. So, in Chandogya, what he writes is the following. Says, Bahusyam Prajayaya. Brahman thought, okay, I will become many. Okay. Now, to become many, okay, how can it become? Only one is there. How can it become many? He gives the examples like this. Yatha murdghata dhyakarena. Bolo? Yatha. Yatha va. Rajvadi sarpadhyakarena buddhi parikalpitena. He does not say avidyakalpitena, remember that. Every word. I have never seen a writer like this. Not a single word anywhere is misplaced. Okay. See, yatha murdghata dhyakarena, yatha va rajvad sarpa dhyakarena buddhi parikalpitena. See how it is? Now what drishtanta is for what? Drishtanta is for one becoming many. Okay. Now, the same one and the same clay is becoming many utensils, parts, bricks, trails, so many things. So, that example is over. Then, yatha rajvad sarpadhyakarena buddhi parikalpitena. That is, I imagine a raju, that is a rope, I imagine for a snake. Somebody else imagines for a crack in the ground. Another person imagines as, some bullock is going and it has urinated. Okay. That is, the same rope is being imagined as something different from it. Okay. That is buddhi parikalpana. Okay. Therefore, what does it mean? It means that you are imagining in this example, the many are there. Though there are many, actually all of them are conceived only with respect to one single rope. The rope is one, but it is being imagined as many. Okay. Similarly, here also, only one Brahman is there. and you are imagining it as many. Many now you take with respect to the jivas. See, many you have already exhausted there, murdghata. In murdghata, many has already come. Now this is explanation for nimitta karana. Therefore, one becoming many is the same Brahman is becoming many. Vishwa, Tejasa, Prajna, up to me, everybody.
This is also explaining why jivas are not born. They are imagined. It is imagined as defense.
Ah, that's right. They are not born. That's right. That is why they are imagined. They are imagined. There is only one actually.
Ocean and drops.
Huh?
Swamiji, the ocean and drop, there can be many drops the same.
That's right. That's also there. But there is a kārikās bhāva there. Drops in the make it.
Waves
huh?
In the ocean.
Waves in the ocean also. But there is kārikās bhāva. With respect to jīva, it is without kārikās bhāva. That is the thing you have to remember. That is why, when it is referring to the nimitta karana, he is telling, yatha rajvada sarpadhyakarena buddhi parikalpitena. It is for nimitta karana, he is giving. Is it all right?
In the very same statement, both are covered.
Both are covered. In one statement, both are covered. Okay. Now, you see, this is some by something we are imagining in bhāṣya vākya. No, no. Bhāṣya confirms this thinking. Further, says, all these objects that you are seeing have only started from Brahmamānasa Pratyaya. Brahmamānasa Pratyaya is Brahman's mental pictures. It is only those pictures that have taken this form. Okay. In fact, that is why the first creatures who are born, like Saptarshi, Manu, Shatarupa, Kardam Prajapati, Daksha Prajapati, okay? All these people are Brahmamānasa Putra, Putri, Ahalya. They are born straight from his thought. Straight from his thought means what? It is thought afterwards he produces. Yeah. What does that mean? Their bodies are produced. They are produced straight from the earth. I think I have told this. Don't know. They are born straight from the earth. That is, they are born like plants. And in the very first shot, the greatest people are born. But this is the Vedic evolution theory. Because the coming generations have to be properly educated. Isn't it so? You understand? Don't think people gradually become cultured. People gradually become uncultured. That is actually the situation. Okay. All I know, they were monkeys and gradually they become human beings. It's simply really illogical. Because monkeys want to continue as monkeys. They don't want to evolve into human beings. Okay.
Theory of human evolution
fails. Let it. What does it matter? Such theories come and go umpteen times, not once. For your information, take Darwin's book. Somebody has counted there. In that book, he uses words like this: most probably, in all likelihood, I think, I guess. Such phrases, 800 places are there. In one book on evolution, if you have I think phrases 800, what sort of a theory it is? In chemistry and physics, do you say I think? Is there I think? There is no I think there. It is there. All just imagination. Yes?
Word is mithya.
No, I didn't tell you.
This.
No. Throughout we have been telling it is not mithya.
Word is mithya, you have told 110 times.
No, I have not told.
You are reading examples from word only, which can't be representative of God.
No,
you see that you are giving examples from the word. It cannot be representative of God because
the
world is mithya.
I did not say the world is mithya. Okay. So now understand? Therefore, even physical theories are failing. But their failing is not such a disaster like this. It will be they will be partly correct. Sometimes it will become wrong. And so they will have to improve. It's not like this, it's full of imagination. It's only imagination. That's all. Okay. This is about leave it. So therefore, with kārikān bhava, you have got murdhgat drishtanta. Without kārikān bhava, you have got rajasarp drishtanta. Both cases ananyatva, non-difference. Next, you should make an important observation. This is the following. The next thing is the following. Now, you have understood that everything is Brahman. Okay. It has been repeatedly told that everything is Brahman. Okay. Now, when everything is Brahman, you should not see anything different from that. Okay. Now suppose you see something different, there is one description of the object. That's called mithya. Okay? Adimitya, once again, listen. Everything is Brahman only, therefore it is not mithya, it is sat. But if someone sees it different from Brahman, which is wrong, that is mithya. Okay? Therefore, mithya is a result of wrong knowledge. Whenever there is mithya jnana, two things are mixed up. What is the mixture? The mixture is the actually real object in front of you and a wrong memory in your mind. These two are mixed up. The object in front is the rope. but the serpent is in your memory. You are mixing the two. Therefore, it is a mithuna between the correct object and a wrong understanding. Therefore, whenever you say you are mithya, there are two things, two different things, a wrong smriti and a right object. Okay. Śankarācārya explains this as koyam adhyāso nāma iti ucchate smriti rūpaha paratra pūrva drishta avabhāsaha. That is, I am seeing the rope. I remember a serpent. What happens is, the moment I see, I don't try to verify. Simply some jnana is there. This jnana is called samanya jnana. Some object. Okay. And that some object triggers a memory in me. That is something like similar to sarpa. Therefore, I hold on the memory firmly. Then I go on seeing it there. Paratra. Okay. In samyajnana, it is not like that. Samyajnana, there is only object and your understanding. You don't mix up your memory with it. That is samyajnana.
Swamiji, if I go out of the way, this mithya jnana can come from my prarabdha also?
No. See, jnana has nothing to do with karma. Jnana has nothing to do with karma. That is, the two are different. This comes only because of ignorance. That's all. Anybody may get it. Alright? Therefore, you see, suppose somebody is telling that this is different from Brahman. Why does he tell it? He tells it for the following reason. Are you are telling Brahman so, this is like this. It cannot be. Therefore, it is different. That's what he is telling. Is it not so? In fact, there is not even any resemblance between the two. See, in the case of Rajju Sarpa, okay, there is a resemblance. But in the case of Brahman and Jaga, there is no resemblance. There is no similarity at all. Okay. Therefore, when you say that it is this, there is no similarity also. Therefore, I don't believe it. It is something different. Okay. Then it says, look here. What you are seeing here, is only a word. It has no meaning. When you say, this door, okay. This door is nothing but wood. That is the right knowledge. Is it not so? Now, what is the position of, what is the value of the word door, this door? What is this door means? After all, wood only. Why did you call it as that? Say. Then you say, see, this is a word in order to make you understand that it is wood. Actually, you are seeing wood, but you are not understanding it, you are seeing only as this door. Therefore, this door is nothing but wood. In order to teach wood, you are using the word door. Have you understood now? In other words, in order to teach Brahman, I use the words of jagat. See, this is Brahman, that is Brahman, that is Brahman, all these things are Brahman. That is, keeping kārikās bhāva in my mind, I say, this is Brahman. When I say, this is Brahman, this is very dissimilar to Brahman. The first difference is this, I am seeing it. Brahman is, I am not seeing it. Okay. though you are saying it and though you are not saying it, remember there is this Brahman. Look at it from the point of the cause. See here, everywhere it is so. Now, I want to know what gold is. I ask one of you, what is gold? You say, what is gold? See this? This is gold. They show a ring. Okay. I didn't want to force. I am asking for gold. She is showing me a ring. I know what a ring is. I don't know what is gold. Okay. Then I went to another person. What is gold? Say that. What did she show? A bangle. So and somebody similarly, somebody else a necklace. Okay. Then I think over. What is this? Every time I am asking for gold, everybody is showing something else. Therefore, there is something wrong with me. What is that? All these things are only gold. But this is only a shape, that's all. This is only a shape, but shape has its meaning only to this extent. What is the extent? So that through that I may recognize the gold. Therefore, with respect to kārikāna bhāva, when jagat is to be explained as Brahman, the Shruti says, vācārambhaṇam vikāro nāmadheyam. It is a name, it is a shape, it is vācārambhaṇa. What is vācārambhaṇa? Bhāṣyakāra defines it. All of you repeat once. Vācārambhaṇam. Vāgārambhaṇam. Vāgālambhaṇam. Ityetat. That is vācārambhaṇa is told by Shruti. He explains it. Vācārambhaṇa means vāgārambhaṇam. That is, with this word I start to tell it. With this word I start to tell it. Therefore, in that sense, it is vāgārambhaṇam. What is vāgālambhaṇam? I take this word as support. Ālambhaṇa is support. I take this word as support to show that this is nothing but that. Nothing but the cause. Therefore, when Bhāṣyakāra says vācārambhaṇam, vāgārambhaṇam, vāgālambhaṇam, all these words are keeping kārikāna ananyatva in view and using the words. Now, where there is no kārikāna bhāva, how is it to be conveyed? That's the question. Have you understood? There is no kārikāna bhāva, but still there is ananyatva. One example is the jīva. Okay. Now, another thing you see here. Take for instance, one fellow has mistaken the rope for a snake. Hey, look here. This snake is nothing but rope, he says. Just as you say, this door is nothing but wood. The same identical sentence. No difference at all. This snake is nothing but rope. There is no difference in the sentence structure. But there is no kārikāna bhāva. Okay. In this situation, Shastra tells, what it is referring to is not the object. In kārikāna bhāva, it is referring to an object and related cause. In the case when there is no kārikāna bhāva, but there is ananyatva, your mistaken notion is taken to correct you. This snake is nothing but rope. When you say, what is this snake? There is no snake at all. What do you mean by this snake? This snake implies a long sentence. This snake, which is actually in your head, but for you, which appears here, the long sentence, you call this snake. Have you understood what is this snake? The snake which is all only in your head, not here, but you are seeing here, this snake is nothing but rope. There is no kārikānubhava here. Similarly here, this jīva, okay, which you are thinking as jīva, jīva, is not jīva, it is Brahman. The rope is this. Did you follow? Now, here also notice now. Here also, you are starting from the walk. There is this snake. You are using a word. There is also a vikara. Okay. There is also a name, Namadheya. Namadheya is there, vikara is there, oh, walk is also there. But there is no connection between the with the cause. Okay. In that case, you say, there is no kārikānubhava. What is you are seeing is adhyastha, and what you have to see is the adhiṣṭhāna. Therefore, the purpose of Rajasarpa Drishtanta is not to show the object. It is to correct your misunderstanding. What is the purpose of Rajasarpa Drishtanta? It is only to correct. That walk that you are using as this snake is really misnomer. It is not, there is no snake at all there. But still you are using it. Okay. Then you say, it is only walk, nothing else. It's only Namadheya, only a name. There is no stuff there, there is nothing. You say that. Have you understood? See, once again I will repeat. The same word vācārambhaṇam is used in two different senses. One, when there is kārikānubhava. Okay. Another time when there is no kārikānubhava. Okay. Now, when there is kārikānubhava, you know how it is. Āravata means, that is, you can analyze, you have to use your brains, okay, and work it out. There is a proof, you have to be intelligent, you have to be alert, you can follow and understand. In that case, vāgārambhaṇam, vāgālambhaṇam. But in the other case, vācārambhaṇam means just simply a word. There is no stuff. Simply a name. That's all. There is nothing like that. And what is its purpose? There is no logic here. You work it out like this. Finally you understand. It's not that. Just don't be foolish. Look carefully. It means only that. Have you understood the difference? In vācārambhaṇam, vāgālambhaṇam, in order to understand ananyatva, we have to use our brains. When you say it is only one, nothing else, in the case of adhyasa, when you use that, you are not proving anything. You foolish fellow, correct yourself. There is a lot of difference between the two. Understand this. So, this applies not only in the case of jiva and this. This applies in the case of kārikānubhava also. I have told kārikānubhava. It has been proved beyond doubt that everything is Brahman. Okay. In spite of it, you will say, you are saying it's Brahman. What is this? I am seeing something. Arre, this is only like a sarpa. It is only rope. See, now, you don't have to invoke kārikānubhava because you have already told it. But in spite of it, it is not possible for him to. Therefore, don't go on hampering on the difference. There could be a lot of difference. Once there is a snake, there is a rope, lot of difference is there. But in spite of it, you mistake. Just as you have mistaken there, you are also mistaking here. This Brahman, recognize it.
Swami, in Raju Sarp, we mistook the Raju or Sarp because there was a similarity in shape or some darkness or there was something.
Yes.
But what is the similarity between Brahman and Jagat that we are mistaking?
That you are being me mistaken. Okay. Have you understood the question? The question is, whenever there is adhyasa, there must be similarity. In the case of rope and snake, there is a similarity. In the case of shell and silver, there is similarity. You can't imagine a snake in a shell and silver in a rope. Okay. There must be similarity. But in between Brahman, there is no similarity at all. Okay. There is one similarity. What is that? Existence is one similarity. But apart from that, remember, I am getting happiness from this. Vishaya. I am getting happiness from this as Vishaya. Brahman is also Ananda Swarupa. Is not Brahman Ananda Swarupa? Therefore, between Brahman and this Vishaya, there is similarity. I am getting Ananda from this. Otherwise, how could I get Ananda? There is Ananda there also. And there is Ananda, same Ananda is here. The two Anandas are the same. But what has happened is, I take it and I think it is coming from the object. It is not so. I got the Ananda only because during that time when I got Ananda, this difference between the two was lost. What is the difference between the two? The object that I am holding and the experiencer. The difference between the two is there. That is lost. The connection is lost.
You experience
Ananda. Yes. Therefore, you say that, Ananda is a similarity thing. It is possible to mistake. There is also a similarity. That is also there. He is also here. Okay. Therefore, what is the end result? The end result is, vācārambhaṇam vikāro nādhyam, it says, it has two meanings. One with respect to kārikānubhava, another with respect to adhyāsa, correcting adhyāsa. In both cases, there is ananyatva. Ananyatva is to be established through kārikānubhava there. Okay. Ananyatva, there is no question of ananyatva here. It is actually wrong. Okay. This example is given only to explain the meaning of vācārambhaṇa. It's only walk, only correct yourself. This example is coming by because the two meanings of vācārambhaṇa are explained here. Have all of you understood? Therefore, Ashikara says here. So, different people are giving different thing. So, Śankarācārya says, Adha tachintayam eva adaro mumukshunam haryanam nishpriyosanayam sritto adraha. They are interested in knowing only ananyatva. Srishti is not important for them. Okay? Don't mistake this sentence for that. Oh, because we are not interested, Srishti Krama can be whatever it could be whatever, don't imagine. There is a karma there, but we are not interested in it. Okay. Then, Bhogartham Srutirtenya Kridartham Ichapare Devasyesha Swabhavoyim Haptakam Sakas Purha. This is important. See, look here. This is Deva Swabhava. What is Deva Swabhava? That is, it is Ishvara's Brahman Swabhava that it is appearing like all these things. Oh, in order to satisfy my samskaras, my karma. Look here. Actually, mantra there is the following. Rupam, rupam, pratirupo, babhuva, tatasya rupam, pratijakshanaya. Indro maya bhipuru rupa iyate. Iyate means appears. Indra means Brahman. Maya bhihi, which is mayas. He is appearing in different forms. What is maya bhihi? There is only one maya we had understood. Okay. Maya bhihi is this. It is following our avidya. It is following our avidya. There are different samskaras. Okay? That is, each person has his own prajna. Each person has his own mithya abhimana. Okay? And according to mithya abhimana, according to his own different prajna samskara, he is appearing in different ways. In other words, what is just? Just is, according to one's own karma the jiva have accumulated, Brahman is appearing in that body form. He is mainly referring here to jivas. Remember this. Did you follow? See here, all the bodies are nothing but the manifestations of Brahman. Okay. Why did you take so many shapes? Like this. Maya bhihi. That is, in order to satisfy the different samskaras and the different karmas of each jiva. Therefore, this idea must be ingrained. Everybody, everything is Brahman, everything is God, everything is God. Therefore, the whole Shastra, the scheme, gives you a scheme. You call all little girls in Navaratri. They're all little girls, 5 years, 6 years, 8 years. And all big people do puja to them and do namaskar. Do they do it or not? You call small children, Brahmachari. All big fellows do namaskar to him. Why? Because there is Brahman. And you do puja to stones, puja to agni, puja to water, puja to even akasha. You know, inchadamara. Only there is a gap. There is nothing. But there is Brahman. There is God. Have understood? There are people who don't understand the depth of this dharma. Okay. Go on talking like, you know, babies. They don't know anything. They don't even look at this common feature. This dharma is surviving like anything. Everybody is coming and going. They don't notice it. Okay. And also they think that they are intellectuals. That is the trouble. Therefore, that everything is nothing but God is a lesson that is to be imparted by the Shastra. It is exactly that is doing that. Okay? Let's stop here. Bolo. Shruti.
Yoga Vatya Padevaya Dakshinamu